Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam, my name is Diego, and today I'll be covering some super beginner Marvelous Designer tips. Why? Because Marvelous Designer, at least from what I saw, is one of these softwares that you know, kind of use if you need it just to create some cushions or pillows or something. I think a lot of people kind of go into the whole Marvelous thing just casually because they need a cushion right now or something. And then after some time, they just progress to something more serious. Well, speaking of that, I kind of noticed that I had some things that I wish I knew when I started using Marvelous Designer. And when talking to other artists, I also noticed that they were struggling with the same thing. So I kind of decided to do this super beginner quick tip intro about Marvelous Designer. So whenever you import your avatar into Marvelous Designer and you want to, you know, just put fabric around it, for example, this is like a seating cushion, and when you would just hit space, it kind of gets super loose, and at that point you're just, you know, struggling to get things looking right, and it's just a mess and it can kind of wreck your nerves a lot. So one thing that I like to do whenever I'm kind of wrapping my garments around my avatar is select all your patterns here and set pressure to minus 70. So minus 70 will literally act like a magnet, and it will just glue to the avatar like a magnet. The other thing that I like to do is click on fabric, scroll down to the preset, and change preset to just go down, 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 and change it to trim full grain leather. Now, trim full grain leather will kind of keep all the, you know, garments and patterns in a solid shape, and it will literally just wrap around. And this is always my starting point. So now look at this. When I hit space, it literally looks, you know, just wrapped around it. Nothing is wrinkling. That's the whole thing about full grain leather. Nothing wrinkles. So it's just a base start. And from this point, I, you know, freeze stuff, unfreeze, change my fabrics to something else, and I just proceed with my modeling. The next thing that I wish that somebody told me when I started using Marvelous is, for example, when you create like a rectangle, and if you go here and go down to smooth curve, you know, smooth curve does this, so you can just create these kind of chamfered angles. So I would always eyeball them. If I need to do, you know, like some specific thing, I would eyeball them, and then, you know, usually they would all be different sizes. Well, there is of course way to kind of make that more precise. So what you can do, hold left click, just click right click while holding the left one, and it will open up this little window where you can actually define how much of the curve you want. So in this example, I, let's say, want 10 centimeters here. You click here, right click again, 10 centimeters, and you now have all precise four edges. And that was, yeah, I wish somebody told me that. Now, another thing, whenever I would, you know, do some garments here, I know, you know, whenever you create something, you get, for example, you get this little window where you put in all your centimeters, etc. But while working with all these garments, I always wanted to know, you know, also how much I'm moving something, etc., and what, you know, amount of centimeters. So I kind of discovered this super nice shortcut. It's Shift Z. When you press Shift Z, it will just display all the centimeters of everything. And now look at this. If you want to, for example, move this pattern to the left, it will also show you. You can see in the little purple numbers up on top, you can actually see how much you're offsetting something. Again, right click, and you can just type the exact number of how much you want to move things. The next thing that I always wanted to learn were pins. So whenever I would have a fabric that I wanted, you know, to kind of stick somewhere or be in the precise position somewhere, etc., I would always just try to maneuver it and, you know, hold space and just try to freeze it or whatever. Well, pins come in that. So pins are literally, you know, like needles that you place inside your fabric, and they're gonna stay in place. So how do you deal with pins? So it's very simple. Just hold W. So press W, and you can just click here, 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 here. And when you click a space, they will just stay here. And you can do actually really nice curtains with this. You can even move pins. So if you click on a pin, you can actually move it and it will just stay in place. So now that you've placed all these four pins, which are gonna, like I said, put the whole thing in place, if you wanna, for example, have these pins attached to your avatar, you can just right click on a pin, and you have attach all pins to avatar. You click that and they're gonna attach here. And now when you press space, you can nicely maneuver how things you want to look, where you want them to be. So yeah, pins are actually super important. If at any point you just don't wish to have your pins anymore, you can just go Control W and it will remove all the pins. So look at this, Control W, bam, all the pins are gone, and you can just toss your fabric into hell or do whatever you want with it. And yeah, those are my few beginner, super beginner tips for Marvelous Designer that I wish I knew before. I might create more of these videos, but we'll see. But before we end up the whole thing, you know what time it is. It's Evermotion time, and Evermotion website, if you go there, if you're using Cinema 4D, you have Arc Interiors Volume 64 and 25% off. On the other hand, check out Evermotion. Their new redesigned website is amazing to navigate. Of course, go to news, and in the news you can see all the different things that are happening around our CGI Archiviz world. And yeah, check out the website. Visit the shop. It's fun there. See you in the next video. Bye.